Hello students, welcome to the session. We are discussing topics in forensic medicine and today we are going to talk about medical law and ethics. So knowing the law and what's ethical is important in healthcare administration, right? Anybody who's a medical practitioner should know what the law has laid out. What are ethics basically? Ethics are derived from the Greek word ethikos, which means the rules of conduct that govern the natural disposition of human beings. Now, what are rules of conduct? Rules of performing activities or rules of practicing the medicine that governs the natural disposition of human beings. We as human beings live as a part of a society, and when we interact with other people, especially as doctors, we need to maintain the professional, we should be very professional when we perform and practice medicine. So ethics basically tell us how we can practice medicine according to the law. Medical ethics is defined as the moral principles. What are moral principles? Those are basic values which should guide the members of the medical profession in their dealings with one another. It could be dealing with the co-workers or colleagues, or it could be dealing with other paramedical staff, with the patients and with the state. So medical ethics are basically voluntary, so the doctors would take it upon themselves, because they would have to follow their conscience, and it is voluntary, self-imposed. It would be a part of their conditioned reflex to respond to their patients, to respond to the demand of the situation, to whatever knowledge they possess. They should be able to practice it in a meaningful way. So it is a voluntary, self-imposed code of conduct, that is behavior and attitude, which has to be cultivated by people of the medical profession. The broad principles of medical ethics are formulated by the national and the state medical councils and also the World Medical Association. In India, we have state medical councils, we also have a central council, and we have the World Medical Association. So these are legislative bodies which lay down the rules and regulations which have to be followed by all medical practitioners. Historically, if you ask me how the medical ethics came into existence, they can be traced back to the guidelines on the duty of physicians, which was given by the Hippocratic Oath. Now, do you know what is the modernized version of the Hippocratic Oath? It is nothing but the Declaration of Geneva, right? You can go back and read about how and when Declaration of Geneva came into existence, but that is what usually guides the medical practitioners to practice medicine. Okay. Now, there's a difference between medical ethics and medical etiquette. Medical etiquette are basically conventional laws of courtesy which is observed between the members of the medical profession. So it talks about how to give respect to your colleagues and co-workers when you're practicing medicine between the members of the medical profession, how to maintain professional standards when dealing with people. So that is the meaning of medical etiquette, and ethics are basically voluntary, self-imposed code of conduct which needs to be followed by all the doctors. Now, when we talk about the moral principles, there are basically four moral principles or basic values which are the foundation stone of ethics. So one is the do no harm, and the second would be beneficence, which means to provide benefit, to take care of the health of the patient, autonomy, and justice. Okay. So beneficence is to do good, non-maleficence is to do no harm. Autonomy talks about the freedom or the boundaries which have to be laid out when it comes to practice, and justice. So whenever any medical practice is done, it has to uphold the principle of fairness and equality. Okay, this is very important. These are the basic values when it comes to defining the medical ethics. There's something called the Indian Medical Council, which is a legislative body and talks about how medical education is recognized, how to lay down the syllabus when it comes to medical education, how to recognize foreign medical qualification, how to maintain a medical register. So medical register is something the doctors who have completed or graduated medical school, they would have to register themselves and their names come into the medical register. If they obtain further degree, they'll have to update the information in the medical register. And if they perform professional misconduct, we'll talk about what is professional misconduct, they would be liable to disciplinary actions. They may violate certain laws, and that would lead the government to take certain disciplinary actions against them the government usually issues a warning notice, and in case of warning notice, if, depending on the kind of crime which is done, it could be penal erasure or it could be professional death sentence, where the doctor would be basically their professional status that would be confiscated. Okay, we'll talk about it, but there are certain aspects which you should know, like there are warning notices which are issued against those doctors who perform indisciplinary, dishonorable activities. All that is maintained by the Indian Medical Council, okay, with, in which we have a medical register. So what is professional misconduct basically? It is the conduct of the doctor which might reasonably be regarded as disrespectful or dishonorable. Okay, so they're doing something which violates the medical ethics. Okay, and this involves an abuse of their professional position. So the 6 A's of professional misconduct, so you can remember it under 6 A's. So one is the adultery. Adultery is basically, in layman language, it's cheating on the spouse, but here it means to having voluntary sexual intercourse with somebody of the medical fraternity who like colleagues, or it could be the doctor who's having that with a patient. So that is adultery. And advertising, so doctors are not supposed to advertise the details of their clinic on huge hoardings, that is not allowed. However, a doctor can write articles, they can disclose information, they can talk about it on social media, but they're not supposed to display information which is huge, like on the hoardings or in newspaper, other than the details which is supposed to be given, like their qualification and name. But there are many doctors who misuse and they misuse they do advertising that comes under professional misconduct. Then doing criminal abortions, that is illegal kind of surgeries, which is against the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act, which came out in 1971, which keeps getting amended. So if they violate that and they perform criminal abortion, that also becomes ground for professional misconduct. And association with unqualified persons, there are people who practice medicine which is not evidence-based. They could be doing they could be committing what is called quackery. If they associate with such unqualified persons, that would commit to professional misconduct. And the doctors who get addicted to drugs which are easily accessible to them, like tramadol, opioids like morphine. So if they get addicted to drugs and they do surgeries, and that could lead to negligence, that could cost the life of the patient, and they may be addicted to alcohol and other substances. So all this amounts to professional misconduct.